All right, folks, God bless you. You know how pilots used to know they were over the target, during wartime? When they took on the most fire. That's how you know you're over the target. So I was suspended for a week again. Anyway, but let me show you how to go to another format or another platform. So let me show you this. You can go to Brighteon, Brighteon dot com slash forward channels slash forward the Jonathan Kleck. Okay, so you can go there, and I've started populating Dave the Wave and Lee, and some buddies are helping me out, and we're putting stuff over there. So you guys, in case something happens and YouTube's no longer available, that's where everyone should go. What I would like everyone to do very soon, please go over to Brighteon and start watching some videos over there, because it increases the view count over there and we get things rolling. Let me show you something real quick. Let me show you something that turns out to be a little bit of a problem. Let's see. Hang on one sec. Okay, so anyway, this is my YouTube channel right here, and these are videos. Let me show you right here. This was removed right here. The video that was removed right here, is called Rex's Raptors and Sheep. Oh my, right here. See, it was removed. It says terms and policies and one more, plus one more. What it originally said was medical misinformation. I read straight out of Wikipedia, about raptor RNA, straight out of Wikipedia. Anyway, so go watch that video over at the other platform. If it was that important to take down over reading Wikipedia, then okay. And you can go over there and we can chat about it over there. But let me show you what's going on right now. I have the most exciting news for you guys. We are arriving right now. Now, guys, do y'all remember, for those of y'all that have been here a long time, y'all remember I told y'all a long time ago, the Lord told me to put my personal testimony on YouTube. And I was like, Lord, no, please. I don't want to do that, please. And he said, you have to. And so when he tells me you have to do something, I do it. Sometimes I ask otherwise, but I'm like, do I have to? And he's like, absolutely, you have to. So I did, and I thank God I did. Remember the 100% no lying? How that's turned out to be like one of the probably the most important revelation here in the end of the world you could ever even imagine, because in order to see the truth, you have to invert everything 100% nylon, turn it upside down, 100% no lying. That's how everything got unlocked. The key to the kingdom of heaven, the key of David, all the data that the Lord God's allowed me to share with you came from that moment in the hotel. And then I went down and got saved in the alley. And then the Lord filled me with the Spirit, and I was able to put forth all this information to you guys from the most simple truth there is. Could it really be that simple? Could it really be that simple? It's that simple. So anyway, so what I'm going to do now is I'm going to go remind everybody what I said after the Lord told me turn it upside down, the words no line or nylon, I'm sorry, the word nylon. And I turned it upside down, it was 100% no lying. So if you want to know the truth, Jesus is the truth, you have to invert the whole system to see the truth. To see Jesus, you invert everything. So now my testimony is going to freak everybody out, because there was a very important thing that was said right after the Lord told me to turn the tag upside down that said 100% nylon, turned it upside down, it was 100% no line. And then what? Then it was, look at the next shirt. Do y'all remember what it was? Y'all remember? The Lord said, it was a triangle with an X through it. And I had no idea. I was like, what does that mean? And the Lord said, the pyramid is your enemy. Remember that? For those of y'all that have been here a long time, y'all remember that? Remember, I told you the night I got saved, I was swamped by all these police. I was arrested by so many police. It was insane. It was like a terroristic event. All these cops were everywhere for walking across the street. Whatever. And I knew right then it was like a pack of insects. I know they were all coming towards me. I was like, what the hell is going on? And I couldn't quite process it. Well, what did I just show you with the let us make man in our image? Elohim said, not the Lord God, not the self-existent eternal Jehovah. That's not him in Genesis 1. Y'all ready? His purpose, Jesus, was to make one new man from the two, thus making peace. He's the Prince of Peace, and he makes peace inside of you. I can't wait to share this with you. The time is here, guys. The time is arriving right now. You ready? All right. Let me show you what we're going to use. I'm going to show you a couple different things. We're going to use Jonathan Kleck's personal testimony from July 25th, 2013. I'm going to use just a little clip from here. We're going to use Tucker Carlson, Americans Deserve to Know the Truth About UFOs. I'm going to show you the meaning of the name Russell. It means red-skinned from reddish skin and the suffix EL, redskin. Y'all remember, what does the name Adam mean? Let us make man, Adam. Y'all know what the word Adam means from Genesis 1? So Elohim said, let us make man, Adam. It means a human being, a hypocrite, but the first word is ruddy. Do you know what ruddy means? The base of the word red, to be dyed and made red. So the word Adam, or the word man, Adam, is ruddy, a human being, hypocrite. And the root of the word 119 is to show blood in the face, to be dyed or made red. Don't forget that, because this is going to be awesome. Let me show you the meaning of the name Russell. Reddish skin from the suffix L. Let me show you. There you go. I showed you Adam already. And let me show you the name Omaha. It means upstream people. Omaha. There's up and then there's down in the Bible. Remember, this is the key to the kingdom of heaven. There's the up and there's the down. The up got mixed with the down. That's the whole system. I do it all the time. And in order to get converted, you got to get both turned up. I've said it over and over and over until everybody's like, okay, quit saying it, Clack. It's the most important thing there is, and understanding the system. Now, ready? Here it comes, guys. They're front-loading the alien disclosure now. And watch, just watch. It's gonna be fun. Okay, let's do it. Let's do it. Here we go. Let me get all this ready. All right. I'm gonna show you an 8-minute, 21-second video right here. And it's just got a couple clips in it. Pay attention, and then after that, we're gonna look at a little clip from the movie Oblivion right here. Okay, so let's do this. Here we go. All right, with no further ado, let's do it. Ready? Here we go. St. Anthony Hotel, and that's where this all started. And so now I've set up the whole story. Don't forget, I was looking for the real Jesus. I wanted to know who the real Jesus was and what the truth was. And all this stuff started happening. It was like some out of a spy movie. It was the
Born
weirdest thing
Identity.
I've ever seen in my life. It was like Born, yeah, it was. It was like Born Identity. It
Wow.
was so bizarre. I could not believe it. And so we got a room at the St. Anthony. We were on the 10th floor. And we went down there, and it was night. And I was
with Lou, and I was in the room, and it was approximately almost 12 a.m., a little after 12. And I said, "Okay, your flight leaves in the morning. You know, here's your ticket. Here's," and I had like two shirts and a pair of pants in my hands, and you know that were. I was getting ready to walk out the door. I'd given her a ticket. I said, "Okay, here's the deal. You know, you're gonna go to the airport in the morning. You're going to Minnesota. I'm gonna go back to my house. When I figure out what's going on, I'll call you, but you'll be safer here, and I'll go to my house because if anyone's trying to hurt anyone, they're trying to hurt me. That way you're not with me, and that way you're safe." And that was the deal. And so I was standing there in the room, and then out of nowhere, it was like an invisible blanket just came over me, and it just all of a sudden I was literally surrounded by, the only way to describe it is like energy. And I held my hands out in front of my face, and I looked at the backs of my hands, and the hair on my hands and the hair on my arms was sticking straight up. And I heard this voice very clearly say, "Read the tags in your shirts." And I looked at Lou and I went, "Some source is communicating with me." And she looked at me and she went, "What?" And I said, "Some source is communicating with me. He's telling me to read the tags in my shirt." And she's like, "What?" And so I'm standing right there by the bed. I throw down my clothes on the bed and I look at the first tag and it said 100% nylon, NYLON. And I went, "100% nylon." And then I heard the voice say, "Turn it upside down." And I went, "Turn it upside down." And so I turned my shirt upside down. He said, "Read it 100%. No lion." Was the word nylon upside down and backwards. And so I said, "100% no line." Like I had my hands held in a suppliant position. That means palms up. I didn't even know why. I'm holding my palms up towards the ceiling, looking at the ceiling, 100% no line. And then my whole body just went, and my body just lit up with electricity. I was like, "Oh my gosh." And then I looked at my arms again. I was like, "What is what?" I was looking at my hands, I was looking at my arms, I was looking at my body going, "What's going on? What is this?" And then I heard, "Look at the other tag," and I looked down, and there was a triangle with an X through it. And I looked at the triangle, and then I heard this voice say, "The pyramid is your enemy." And I went, "The pyramid is my enemy." And then all of a sudden I went, and I buzzed really, really hard. And I was like, "What is going on?" And then all of a sudden it just dissipated.
Just a few days ago, the Pentagon confirmed that a 2019 video of a UFO sighting is actually real. It was a UFO. The video shows a pyramid-shaped object flying over a U.S. Navy destroyer. This is the very first time the public has seen video from this incident. The UFO footage was leaked to a filmmaker called Jeremy Corbell, who joins us tonight to explain all of this. Jeremy, thanks so much for coming on. Tell us where
Thanks for
this
having me,
was
Catherine.
shot. What are we looking at here?
Yeah, so I obtained and released videos and photographic evidence of UFOs swarming our warships. So the green video is night vision. That's from the USS Russell. It wasn't just one pyramid-shaped craft, it was multiple. These were swarms. I also released with my mentor in journalism, George Knapp, also released from the USS Omaha, which looks like thermal imagery. He released three photos the day prior to mine. So we're trying to get this out to continue elevating the conversation because it's very important we have it right now.
Who are you?
Alien.
Alien.
Elohim. We're the original makers. We're the maker of worlds. Make worlds with love.
You made the people.
Yes, you are our children.
What do you look like?
You would find it hard to look upon my face.
Why?
They're different.
Pretty? Or not so pretty?
We think we are, but you probably would think not. We made you in our image. But there are differences.
Who are you?
Alien.
Alien.
Elohim. We're the original makers.
All right, let's take a look at Genesis 1 again. We made you. Elohim said, see, Elohim said, let us make man. Adam, ruddy red. A human being, hypocrite, ruddy red. An R, phantom. That is illusion, resemblance, since a representative figure, especially an idol, vain show. Okay. So now, all of a sudden, out of nowhere, mainstream media, Tucker Carlson. Go watch the entire interview. Go watch the whole thing. Let's look at the name of the battleships where those pyramidal-shaped UFOs were. Let's see. Let's hear the name of those again. Let's hear that name again here on Tucker Carlson.
Where this was shot, what are we looking at here?
Yeah, so I obtained and released videos and photographic evidence of UFOs swarming our warships. So the green video is night vision. That's from the USS Russell. It wasn't just one pyramid-shaped craft. It was multiple. These were swarms. I also released with my mentor in journalism, George Knapp.
UFO. The video shows a pyramid-shaped object flying over a U.S. Navy destroyer. This is the very first time the public has seen video from.
What were the names of those ships again? Let's look. The names of the ship were Russell. It means reddish, red skin. Let's go back to Genesis. Let us. Elohim said. See right here, Elohim, just like the guy in the. Elohim said, let us make man. What does it say? Ruddy. Human being, hypocrite. What does it say? Red. Ruddy. Huh. That just happens to be the name of the battleship? Russell? Russell means red. Man. Adam means red. Let us make man. Oh, that's weird. It's a pyramid. I told you so. Let's do that again. So it means the name of the battleship is the USS Russell. And what's the name of the other battleship? The Upstream People. The name of the other battleship was Omaha. How many times have I told you we are from above, up? They are from below. We're the upstream people. They're the downstream people. Told ya. Bam, bam, bam. Take that, buddy. I told you. Here it comes. Here comes, we're your masters. They may be their masters. Look, they created the human race as a host body system in order to use it as a trap for God's angels that got carried away captive, that took the bait. Over the history of the world, you get injected into a body. If you don't get converted, turned up, you go to the pit and you become food for a race of insects. Hey, let me show you the new helmet line. Let me show you the new helmet line of one of the best moto, one of the best moto racers there is. I still ride bikes. Let me show you just a quick. Here you go. Here's let's see, the Marquez helmet. Let's see. Let's take a look right there. Is that an ant head right here? Is that the head of an ant? Well, in case I'm wrong, let's look at a couple of the other ones. Is that the head of an insect right here? Is that an insect head right here? You know, this guy makes $20 million a year for racing bikes. I'm kind of envious. Let's take a look at that. Is this an ant head? Are those mandibles right there? Are those antenna? Are these legs? Oh, my gosh. Let's look at another one. Oh, my gosh. Is that an ant? Is that an insect? Oh, wait a minute. They're all insects. I told you. I just got through with the let us make man in our image. Well, who's saying that? Elohim. Well, you know, again, the Lord has had me in the Lord's school of biblical knowledge for a long time. A lot of people like to try and come and argue with it, but yeah, that's okay. You can argue with it. You're just insect food. That's it. Sorry. I'm sorry, I'm just a blunt person. I love you in Christ. I'm here to show you the truth. You want to argue? That's okay. You reap what you sow. So here we go. Let's go back and let's run through a little clip from a movie called Oblivion. Okay, you know, without going into the whole storyline, he's leaving the planet surface. He's going up to where his bosses are outside the atmosphere, and he flies his spaceship up there, and let's just take a little watch. Here we go. Kind of looks like an insect. I'm going to just take a moment. How many times have y'all gotten sick of hearing me telling you guys that this is all about a twin system? Twins, one's right side up, and if you put twins in the womb, one's right side up, one's upside down. How many times have I told you the greatest illusion there is male and female? One's right side up, one's upside down. That's the big illusion. Making the human race male and female was just a trap in order to transfer energy from an angel to another system in the pit called demons. So you get the angel trapped in the system called the flesh, the forbidden fruit. Then you can destroy them. When that host body dies, the angel goes to the pit and they get him for good. That's it. That's the mystery of everything. Watch. Here we go. How many times has Jonathan Kleck said it's a male-female twin system? There you go. There you go. There's the male-female twin. What's their number one? Spaceship. It's a big pyramid. And now they're coming out. Oh, I just happened to obtain a video that was leaked to me. Who leaked it to you? Where'd you get it from? Of course, we didn't hear any of that. It was leaked to me. And with my mentor, he got three photos. We're going to go back and listen again. He also has three Angel of the Bottomless Pit of another video. Who leaked it to you? Where'd you get it? How come all of a sudden it's coming out right now? The pyramid is your enemy, Jonathan. Y'all getting this? Let's take a look here again. That's not right side up, upside down, is it? What? I told you. There it is. Wait a minute. What's going on here? What? Was one right side up and one upside down? What? Was one right side up and one upside down? Did I tell you we're all being raised as food? Did I show you that you have this invisible line that goes to the pit where you have your own cell where there's a worm feeding off you? Does this all sound familiar? Like the entire last series I did? Listen, I want to let y'all know the Lord's communicated to me very clearly that the time is at hand. And that he's telling me on a personal level that there's something that I must do. Kind of like Chinati, remember? Y'all remember the miracle and the miracles in Chinati? You remember? Out of billions and trillions, billions of trillions of rocks, the Lord had me look down in a riverbed where my LZ was, and he told me to pick up these two rocks that were apart. They weren't next to each other. They were apart. I showed y'all the video. And he said, now put them together. And I was like, put them together. And they're the exact same rock. Yeah. I told you. Because I'm on the rock. This is the rock. That's what being on the rock is. Knowing this is everything. I love you in Christ. It's proven over and over. So let's watch some more. This is good. It's getting good.
Welcome home, Jack.
Okay, pay attention.
Oh, can a man die better?
You don't have to die, Jack. She doesn't have to die.
Everybody dies, Sally. The thing is to die well.
Jack, that's not the survivor you promised me.
No. It's not. And the temple service gods.
I created you, Jack. I am your god.
That's what I wanted you to get to hear. I created you, Jack. I am your God. And it's the pyramid. Just drive around town and look at all the houses. Look at all the houses with their roofs like this with the circle. It's a hive. The whole thing is a hive. The whole thing, the whole place we're in is a hive. Told you. Now, this movie, I mean, just manifests everything I've been saying, but what I'm really here to tell you is the mainstream media is telling everybody aliens are here. They're in pyramidal shaped crafts and they're smarter than us and they have better technology than us. And they will come out and they will say, we are your creators because it's true. Why do you think you have to be adopted? Because you were carried away captive, you were used as fodder, and unless you get adopted into Christ's family, you end up in the pit. You end up getting burned because the Lord God is going to burn it all. I'm the before the fire guy, V for vengeance. Told you. I don't know what to say, guys. I've had one heck of a day. It's been so crazy. Anyway, so I'm going to make this a short little video. You guys just kind of think about that, but I want to clear some up from the last video. I noticed that a lot of people really don't pay attention. I know I jump around a little bit, but watch. Let me show you guys something real quick. This was really weird. A lot of people didn't get this. Okay, let me show you some on that last video that I was trying to show everybody. I was showing everybody then the Taylor Swift who's sitting on the ceiling with her boyfriend right there. They're sitting there, they're playing a board game, right? And I said, the board game is devils roll the dice and angels roll their eyes, okay? So, 241, look at the dice, 241. And a lot of people were like saying, well, you said 241, but you're showing us 246. Pay attention. That was the whole point. 246 and 241 are the same from disparate sources. Watch. So devils roll the dice, angels roll their eyes. It's 246 and 336. Watch. I'm sorry. 241. 241 right here. And then 336. Watch. Coming out of a raptor hand. Let's look at 241 in the Bible. 241. Allogenes. Allogenes. Of another race. Of another nation. A foreigner. Of another race. Look at the coloring. It's yellow. Yellow. Blue. Blue. Allogenes. 241. Now, let's go back. What now? What's on the other dice? 336. A taking up, destroying, slaying, taking away of life, killing, slaying, murder, destroying. Okay, so what is the connotation of the board game with Taylor Swift that got her boyfriend upside down on the ceiling? A slaughter of another race. That's the whole point. In a reptilian raptor race, devils roll the dice. Who's rolling the dice? The raptor, the reptilian race, the female parthenogenesis, the ones that started it. Devils roll the dice. Angels roll their eyes. Get it? They get their eyes rolled. That's how they destroy them. Now, watch. Pay attention. Here we go. Okay, devils roll the dice. Angels roll their eyes. Now let's look at COVID. How did 246, not 241, 246. 246 fully vaccinated people still get COVID. 246 vaccinated Michiganders. 246 fully vaccinated. 246. Now let's look up 246 in the Strong's Concordance. We're not looking up 241. We're looking up 246. See, it's all in yellow. There's no other color here. 246. Foreigner. Foreign. Of another tribe or race. Of another race. Foreigner. Now, let's go back and look at 241. We just saw 246. Let's see 241. Of another race. A foreigner. Of another race. We're the other race. We're the ones they're destroying. We're the ones that got caught in the twin male-female system. And we are the ones being destroyed by the pyramid that's our enemy. And now they're coming out. Mainstream media. No big deal. No big deal. Oh, there's these pyramids swarming the USS Russell Red. Well, what's the word for Adam? Let us make man Adam Red, ruddy. Human being, hypocrite. Oh, that's pretty wild. I wonder what the odds are. There are no odds. Okay. Oh, the other battleship they're swarming is the Omaha. Oh, what does that mean? The upstream people. Oh, that's weird. The word curse in the Bible just happens to be kata, down. Standing up again is the resurrection. That's like, give me a break. This is done. It's done. They're here. I'm excited, guys. That means my ministry has been right on the money, right over the target since day one. I love you guys. Okay, I'm excited. I'm real excited. That means everything's just going to happen here real soon. Now, I have other testimonies, and guys, they're so supernatural. I mean, I've been on suspension for a week because the Rexes, raptors, and sheep. Oh my. The raptor race is destroying the sheep. I mean, why do you think there's a dead sheep inside the Vatican, which is a big snake? The serpent race is destroying the sheep race. It's like that's all there is to it. End of story. Anyone that wants to argue with it, go ahead, you're not one of us. Or you haven't been adopted, you're still in your sin. Okay, you guys got this? All right. Anyway, go check out Brighteon. Go watch Raptors, Rexes, and Sheep of Mine. Go pay attention when I talk about the RDNA, the RNA, the Raptor RNA. I love you guys. All right, I'm gonna make this short. I'm back. It's like, it's heating up, guys. This is it. Okay, let's get a good hug going. Okay, I need some love. By the way, I love you guys. I want to reach out. I've been trying to reach out to every now and then. What I'll do is, you know, I get letters and stuff, and I sometimes people leave their phone numbers, which is great. I like it if you do, because then the Lord will lead me, and I'll just drop in on somebody. Miss Richie, I'm trying to get your phone number. I'm sending you a card in the mail. Maybe I can get your phone number. I'd like to invite you to meet some friends. Anyway, guys, this is getting very, very exciting. Very exciting. All right. This is you. This is me. I love you. And I'm here to lay down my life for the well-being of all the sheep. I'm a sheep herder. I'm a sheep dog. All right. Ready? Hug. Y'all ready? Get your bear. Go get your bear. Get your pillow. Get your stuffed animal, whatever you need. Wrap it around. Say, I love you, Johnny. I love you guys. We're going to be okay. There's nothing to fear. When you know the truth will set you free. Once you're set free, you have no fear of death, because if the Son sets you free, you're free indeed. There's no death for us. We're eternal beings. We're eternal beings that got out of the trap. The trap was down. And when you get inverted, you get turned back up 100% nylon. Turn it up 100%, no line. Then your eyes become single. Your whole body's full of light, because there's not light and dark. There's only light. The whole body's full of light, and you're good to go. It's all true, guys. It's all good. Jesus is the King of Kings. He's the Lord of Lords. He's the one true God. He is the only, only true God. I don't care what anyone says. I serve the King. All right. I'll be back. If anything happens, y'all know where to go. Okay? All right. Peace and grace.